Good morning, students. How are you? I hope you are doing good in your home. Be safe in your home itself. And I welcome you all to this session. So far in principle of management, we have discussed on what does mean by management, what are all the management styles and techniques, and what are all the how the management is evolves, and what is meant by planning, and what is organizing, what is organization structure, and how can we direct the people, how can we motivate, what is the leadership, and what is meant by communication. So all those things we have discussed so far. Now we are in the verge of completion, so we come to the unit number 5 called controlling. So in the picture itself, it shows what is mean by control. So controlling, where it comes? Controlling comes after planning, that is after doing in action. When the action is in progress, we need to monitor it, we need to assess it, and we have to get feedback. And based on all those things, we are controlling the things step by step to carry out the work and to accomplish our goal, accomplish our task. So this is what the controlling mean for. So what are all the things in controlling? For your syllabus, system and process of controlling, budgetary and non-budgetary control techniques, use of computers and IT in management control, productivity related problems, then what is direct and preventive control, and finally the reporting. So these are all the things which is available in your syllabus. The objective of this lesson is to study various techniques for controlling the functions of management. So what are all the techniques used in controlling? So outcome of this topic is to know about, the students will be able to describe control techniques and role of technology in management. According to Coons and O'Donnell, managerial control implies, they are defining controlling as, managerial control implies measurement of accomplishment against the standard and the correction of deviation to assure attain of objectives according to the plans. So whenever you plan certain things, then you will set certain standards on action. So during the process of work, we ourselves compare the actual progress with the standards. So according to the standards, if any deviation occurs, we are identifying the deviations and variations, and based on that variation, we are reset the progress of the work. So this is called as controlling. So these are all the things to achieve our goal or attain our goal based on the policies, based on the goal, based on the standard we have set on the task. What is the nature of controlling? Usually the controlling is a forward looking, because we don't know what will come. So it is all about forecasting. So these are all the things might come. So based on that, we are having some notion on that, what to do, what should we do, what should not be do. It's a forward looking process. The nature of controlling is goal oriented. So based on the thing is, usually whatever you want to do, so in our daily life itself, we know that you plan one thing, but what is happening is another thing, but still we are moving towards our goal. So even though in these conditions also, we know that how the situations is version, but still we are focusing on our goal. So what to do next? So we are control the things based on we control the things based on our goal, what we are going to achieve. Based on the goal, the control is done. Next point is, the controlling is a pervasive in nature. What has been the pervasive? So in Tamil, I can translate it vyabikirathu. What does it mean by vyabithal? It is spreading. So very first one, so in the picture itself it describes a person gives instruction to another one, and he control other, then he control his subordinates. The things are going in a chain process. Controlling is a continuous process. It's not an end. It's like a life. We are in a constant process. We are in a journey. When in your 10th, you have certain amount of control. In 12th standard, it is also a certain kind of control. In college itself, you again running behind the marks or running behind your certain things. I'm not criticize anything, but you are having certain control over in your during all those study period. So it's a continuous process. For example, I am telling this. Controlling enables to make quick decisions. So it is to we have to take our decisions so quickly and judiciously based on the situation. So the controlling enables to take quick decisions to go ahead. So controlling is based on action. So action based. It is not a planning or it is not a mental process. It is actually a work base. Controlling should be acceptable by everybody. So whatever you are, so it should be acceptable. You can't, if you resist certain things, then automatically you will feel or you will get the loss. It's a collective one. If it is a participative one, in controlling, everybody should be participated, and so based on that we can do some action. Controlling is all about supervising everything in a company. It may be a goal, it may be a persons, it may be a anything. It is an effective supervision. Based on the supervision, we are getting the input that whether the goals are met, if the planning is rightly going, or if we have to recorrect the planning. And based on each and every employee, it shows that employee's performance, and it protects the organization. So controlling is a very important element. It shows the organization's output. So if in every review meetings, the managers will have to show that what is going in and around the company. So on that point, we can get the data about what is the scenario of the company. Whatever the organization, the total data about the complete set of data about a company is shown by the controlling. The relationship between the planning and controlling. So first very most thing in management is planning. We have to plan our goals, objectives, and how we are going to achieve the objectives, called strategies and plans, judiciary plans, to do our actions. So based on the goal objectives, we are organizing the people, organizing the equipments, organizing the machineries. So based on that, we have to lead the team. So in that, it's leading the team, leadership, communication, and individual group behavior. So based on all those things, we are controlling the entire organization. So we have standards. So based on standards, we are measuring the things and we are comparing if there are any discrepancies with the actual action of the standards, we have to recorrect it. So these where we have in control. We are controlling the people, we control the money, we control the elements, each and every elements in the organizations. So this is the link between planning. Planning is the first stage, controlling is in the action stage. Planning is a mental process, controlling is the real-time ongoing process in a company. So with this, I complete this video. In the next video, what are all the types of